like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1. Beloved in Christ, living streams of water is 2 years. It is by the grace of God that we have come this far. The Word that was with the Father and the Holy Spirit has become flesh among us, and we are so happy and joyful. For all those behind the scenes, God richly bless you, especially for our benefactors and benefactresses. You are doing so great.
Oliver asks for more. Continue on to send us the momo. Continue on to support us with your prayers. Your comments and your encouragement is always welcome.
We want to say thank you to you for making time each and every day to watch the living streams of water. The water that brings us joy, growth, nourishment, and love to each other. I say God richly bless you.
Now go there.
Awesome. Yeah, that.
The buyer.
Also, share, subscribe to our YouTube channel and to our Facebook channel, and God will richly journey with us each day. Have a wonderful time.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be done unto me according to your word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh, and it dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Together we pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, you are welcome to Living Streams of Water. Today, would like to reflect with you with the book of Genesis. A reading from the book of Genesis. When Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to Abram and said to him, I am God Almighty. Walk before me and be blameless. And God said to Abram, as for you, you shall keep my covenant, you and the descendants after you, throughout their generations. This is my covenant, which you shall keep between me and you and your descendants after you. Every male among you shall be circumcised. And God said to Abraham, as for Sarai, your wife, you shall call her Sarah, but Sarah shall be her name. I will bless her, and moreover, I will give you a son by her. I will bless her, and she shall be the mother of all nations. Kings of people shall come for her. Then Abraham fell on his face and laughed, and said to himself, "Shall a child be born to me, a man who is 100 years old? Shall Sarah, who is 90 years old, bear a child?" And Abraham said to God, "Oh, that Ishmael might live in your sight." God said, "No, but Sarah, your wife, shall bear you a son, and you shall call his name Isaac. I would establish my covenant with him as an everlasting covenant for his descendants after him. As for Ishmael, I have heard you. Behold, I will bless him and make him fruitful and multiply him exceedingly. He shall be the father of 12 princes, and I will make him a great nation. But I will establish my covenant with Isaac, whom Sarah shall bear to you at this season next year." When he had finished talking with him, God went up from Abraham. The word of the Lord. My dear friends in Christ, it has gotten to a time where God continued to reassure Abraham of his blessings for him. Secondly, of his promises for him. And thirdly, for his own benefit for Ishmael, the son of Hagar. The first. At this time, God wants him to do one thing. He says, "Walk before me and be blameless." Walk before me and be blameless. In some other writings, they will say that walk in righteousness and be blameless. Beloved, this is not about walking sanctimoniously. No. This is not about pretense. No. This is not about wanting everyone to know that you are holy. No. This is about each and every day trying as much as possible to avoid evil and to do good. Beloved, as human as we are, we should not forget that many a times our righteous deeds are those that will send us to heaven because of the intention that we have in doing those righteous deeds. But today, we are called, as Abraham is called, to walk, to be righteous, and to be blameless before God. Scripture tells us that even our righteousness is like a filthy rag in the eyes of God. So it is not about walking sanctimoniously for everybody to recognize that, oh, this is a holy person. No. It is not about flanging your philanthropists around for everyone to know that you are a benefactor to one person or the other. No. God says we should walk before him and be blameless. We should walk in righteousness and be blameless. We should leave all forms of wanting to be known by everybody that it is he or she who does this or that. because holiness, it is not a one-day thing. Becoming blameless before God, it is not that you will never do anything bad. Walking in righteousness does not really mean that you will not do anything evil on this earth. But in as much as that you are conscious that, yes, I have done something bad and I need to repent of it, or each day my mind tells me that this is what I must do and that is the right thing, so God is calling upon each and every one of us to walk beside him and to be blameless. The second thing is about the promises that he offered him. And today, God wants to show us that there is nothing that he, God, cannot do. Medically, as the doctors will say, at the age of 100 years as a man, at the age of 90 years as a woman, there is no or nothing that can make both of you come together, mate, and you have a child. But for God, it is possible. And the possibility is that what we human beings feel that it is impossible and we cannot do, that is where God's hand begins. Beloved, you think God is not aware that you need a child? You think he's not aware that you are jobless? You think he's not aware that you don't even have a single meal to eat each day? Beloved, he has promised and he will never fail. When you think no help is coming from anywhere, that is where he will make a help for you. And when you think that things are so difficult that you can't do anything about it, that is where he makes things very easy for you. Let us trust in him. Let us obey his word. Let us walk before him. And let us know that he is God. For us as human beings, most often, our difficulty is that we don't have patience. And we are not able to persevere. God called Abraham at the age of 75. Today, he is 99, 100. How many years? 15 good years. And he's now coming to give him a child of his own by Sarah, his wife, because Hagar, who was Ishmael, was a slave girl with her. Beloved, there is nothing that God cannot do. The third, it's about the promise to Ishmael. He knew that, Abraham knew that Ishmael is one who was begotten from the slave girl and would now become the prosperity. God says, no. I will give you your own from Sarah. And he will bless him. And you become the man of 12 princes. Yes, that is Ishmael. But his covenant is going to be between him and Isaac. As the story unfolds, let us know that God is God. It is he who rules the world. It is he who knows your beginning and end. And it is he that when he promises, it shall always come to pass. What he asks of you and from me is that we walk with him and we become blameless in his sight. Beloved, one may ask, how can we achieve this? You don't need any form of thing to achieve anything, but you just have to be faithful to the Lord. And faithfulness to the Lord does not mean that you will not have hardships in your life, but faithfulness to the Lord, that each day you do good and avoid evil. May the Lord bless and keep you. May his face shed its light upon you and grant you his peace. May he bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a blessed working day.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1. Beloved in Christ, living streams of water is 2 years. It is by the grace of God that we have come this far. The Word that was with the Father and the Holy Spirit has become flesh among us. And we are so happy and joyful. For all those behind the scenes, God richly bless you. Especially for our benefactors and benefactresses. You are doing so great honor.
Oliver asked for more. Continue on to send us the momo. Continue on to support us with your prayers. Your comments and your encouragement is always welcome.
We want to say thank you to you for making time each and every day to watch the living streams of water. The water that brings us joy, growth, nourishment, and love to each other. I say, God richly bless you.
Now go there.
Asan.
Yeah, that.
The buyer.
Also share, subscribe to our YouTube channel and to our Facebook channel, and God will greatly journey with us each day. Have a wonderful time.